as an actor, you have to sort of disconnect and trust him a lot. Once you guys are on the floor, how much are you still writing? I mean, and still working out as compared to, because it's so much work just trying to stay in character and listen to your director, how much do you get to step outside of that and still sort of shape and change things?
It's the loveliest thing in the world to get to work with an artist that you trust more than yourself. He's sort of like an emotional miniaturist. He'll just come into the scene when it's not working and he'll like whisper something to Alex, and then he'll like whisper something to Toby or me, and then the scene happens again and suddenly it works.
One of the funny things about a scene that you haven't quite gotten is that I would use that scene to audition a lot.
Really?
So yeah, and so, well, that's one of the cool things about, I don't know if actors know this, but a lot of times the director's just learning a lot about the scene from watching like a great actor read it, and then I'll later use that on set, even though that actor didn't get the part.
And obviously Izzy is someone who has an incredible amount of pain, an incredible amount of sadness, and then a lot of that gets covered up by her anger. And I don't think that takes, you know, any validity away from how she feels in regards to the external world. But obviously a lot of that's like sort of, you know, externalized. And that for an actor is obviously a great exploration. And then you hope that that helps it enter the audience, like regardless of how they feel.
I was wary about Juno coming in to read for Izzy. I didn't think. I guess I just don't have much imagination as a director, because I didn't realize that Ellen was playing a part when she was playing Juno. But I think that's actually a problem a lot of times for actors, and that's kind of a short-sightedness on my part. And I was blown away when we sat down with her. Right when we sat down with her, there was just an intelligence in her eyes that I hadn't encountered a lot.
The stakes of Deep Cover are so intense, and I don't know why Zal and I were both so interested about in infiltration stories and the idea of someone who has to lie and who slowly loses their tether to the outside world. Like, you lose the people you can really confide in and be honest to. And in this story, it's particularly hard because she's not telling the truth to anyone. I mean, she's not even telling the truth to her handler or to her boyfriend, so it's lies all around. But I think in large part it's because she doesn't really know who she is to begin with.
Right, let's thank these guys for being here tonight.
Thank you guys.
Thank you guys.